What's up, y'all? Baseball is all about the matchups. It's the pitcher versus the hitter. Who's going to come out on top? It's part of what makes baseball so interesting to watch, so interesting to play, because you have that one-on-one aspect of it. So each team has pitchers. Each team has hitters. Each team has their best pitcher and best hitter. If you put like them together in a duo, who would win in a tournament? So I thought that'd be an interesting concept. So I ranked all 15 American League teams on their duos and ranked all 15 National League teams on their duos. And if there was a World Series of one-on-one baseball, I think the two number one seeds would be who meets. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Like, subscribe, all that stuff. Let's get into it. So at 15, the Kansas City Royals duo comes in. Their best pitcher is Brady Singer. Their best hitter is Salvador Perez. Singer is a young pitcher. It's second year in the league now. Who's been all right. He's just not elite compared to all these other great pitchers. Salvador Perez had a career year, 48 home runs. Just there's some other holes in his game. So that's where they come in at 15. Next, you got John Means and Cedric Mullins. Another team kind of at the bottom. Cedric Mullins' breakout year. He stopped switch hitting. He only batted lefty, and he had an all-star year. He's a true, like, cornerstone center fielder now for Baltimore. Someone to build around. John Means is okay. Next, you have the Tigers, and their two new additions, Eduardo Rodriguez and Javier Baez. Baez, I did an article on him. I'll leave that in the link. He's actually still a really good hitter. I know he strikes out. I know he doesn't walk, but he still has an 800 to 850 OPS. Great defense, although defense doesn't matter in this. Javier Baez is still a really good player. Eduardo Rodriguez is an interesting one. All the analytics like him, and the expected numbers expect him to have a great year, but he's been like a 4 ERA guy in Boston. So they come in at number 13. And number 12, it's the Rays combo. One of the best teams in the league. Don't quite have an elite pitcher yet. It's Shane McClanahan. I'm going with him. Shane Bass is going to be good. They just got so many like pitchers in there. But McClanahan might be the ace this year. And then Wander Franco. I'm choosing Franco over Nelson Cruz, over Randy Rosarena, because this is a tournament that's happening like this offseason, like right now. And I believe in Franco. He's going to be great. Twins come in. And you got Kenta Maeda and Byron Buxton. Buxton is a guy who has tons of other aspects to his game, fielding and speed. But he really is an elite hitter. He had an amazing 2021 before he got injured. Good 2020, good 2019. Just injuries have always been the problem. Kenta Maeda had, I guess, Cy Young-like 2020. Struggled out the gate in 2021. Finished it not terribly. But that's why they fall in at around 11. Just to make sure that is 11, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11. It is. Number 10, you got Oakland, Chris Bassett, and Matt Olson. Who knows if these guys are still going to be on the team next season. But Matt Olson really cemented himself as a top first baseman in this league. And Chris Bassett is a guy that he got hit in the face with a baseball, and he still came back like 2 weeks later and continued to pitch. He's a really good, really solid Oakland A's type pitcher. It was kind of between him or Shamania or even Frankie Montas. Montas had a really good year. I just like Bassett a little bit more. At number 9, you have the Seattle Mariners with AL Cy Young winner Robbie Ray and Mitch Haniger. Haniger had a great year, 35-plus homers, 100-plus RBIs. Robbie Ray won the damn Cy Young. I'm not quite sure if I believe. I think Robbie Ray will have another good year. I don't think it's going to be another Cy Young-type season. New team. It seemed like Pete Walker, the Blue Jays pitching coach, really helped him. He's still going to be a really good pitcher, though. And Mitch Haniger really broke up, had a good, great season. At number 8, it is the Texas Rangers' brand new duo, John Gray, pitcher, solid. Corey Seager, hitter, great. Obviously, I had to decide between Seager and Semien. Seager had better stats, so I went with him. And John Gray's a solid pitcher. They need more pitching if the Texas Rangers want to make the playoffs. At number 7, we have the Chicago White Sox, Lance Lynn, Luis Robert. Robert, give him a full season. He's going to be an MVP candidate. Lance Lynn was a Cy Young candidate the whole year. Just didn't win it. I'm pretty sure he finished third. They're solid. Number 6. Or is this number 6? Yeah, this is number 6. Yes, it's number 6. I'm sorry about that. It is the Boston Red Sox. Chris Sale and Rafael Devers. Chris Sale is a guy that came back from Tommy John surgery and was all right in 2021, but he's been elite before that. Rafael Devers had an amazing breakout season with the Boston Red Sox. And they come in at number 6. Just can't go into that top 5. At the number 5 spot, it is the World Series runners-up. You got Framber Valdez for the Houston Astros and Yordan Alvarez for the hidden side of it. Both these guys, especially Alvarez. Alvarez is so underrated, man. He had an amazing ALCS. He had an amazing season since he came up in 2019. Definitely the best DH in the league. Well, it depends if you count Ohtani in there, but Alvarez's offensive numbers rival Ohtani's for sure. Framber Valdez is he's a good young pitcher. And then you got the Blue Jays coming in at number four. New addition, Kevin Gausman. Gausman is probably better than Robbie Ray. And then Vladimir Guerrero Jr. is your hitter. Vlad's one of the best hitters in the league. Gausman's a solid pitcher, probably like a top 10 to top 15 pitcher in the league. Number three, you got the Cleveland Guardians. Cleveland Guardians are not a good team, but they have a good duo, pitcher-hitter duo. Shane Bieber, 2020 pitching triple crown, 2019 All-Star MVP. He's their pitcher. And then Jose Ramirez, the best third baseman in the league. Third base is so stacked, and he is like the definite best one that it's kind of crazy. If you think about third base, Manny Machado, Matt Chapman, Alex Bregman, Anthony Rendon, Jose Ramirez. I'm sure I'm forgetting other ones, and he's the best one by far. So they come in at number three. Number two is the Yankees. Gerrit Cole arguably could have won the Cy Young in 2021. He arguably could have won it in 2020. I don't even remember who won the 2020 Cy Young in the American League. It seems like a while ago. And then he almost could have won it in 2019, but Verlander won it. Him and then Aaron Judge. Aaron Judge finally stayed healthy, and he had a career season. And then number one, it's Los Angeles Angels duo. It's Shohei Ohtani pitching and Mike Trout hitting. Crazy that Ohtani could be at the top of this list, and he does both. But we know how good Mike Trout is a hitter. Still saying Mike Trout's a better hitter than Shohei Ohtani. I don't think anyone's really going to argue on that. Ohtani is a solid pitcher. He's not at the top of the class. He's just like, he's like a top 15 to top 20 pitcher in the league. But Mike Trout's just such a good hitter that I think even though Cole is a couple levels ahead of Ohtani, Trout's a couple levels ahead of Judge. But you can make an argument. You can make an argument for sure. Let's go to the National League. Then you got the Cubs. You signed Marcus Stroman. Great signing. Your best hitter, unfortunately, is your catcher, Wilson Contreras. So they fall in at 14. At 13, Germán Márquez, who is the best pitcher in Colorado Rockies franchise history. That says a lot about the Colorado Rockies. And CJ Cron. Cron, breakout season. So, I mean, they don't need hitters in Coors. They need pitchers because Germán Márquez is your best pitcher in franchise history. That's crazy. The Marlins come in at number 12. Sandy Alcantara, who they signed to a great deal. He's going to be an elite pitcher. He's a really solid young pitcher right now. Jesus Aguilar is your best hitter. I mean, maybe Jazz Chisholm by the end of next year, but Aguilar is like, I think he's on the wrong side of 30 now. It's not great. Cardinals, I went with Adam Wainwright for their pitcher over Jack Flaherty. They gave the ball to Wainwright in the wild card game. Crazy. And then their best hitter is Tyler O'Neill. It's kind of weird. I think Tyler O'Neill is the best hitter on this team when they have like Nolan Arenado and Paul Goldschmidt. But O'Neill was just so elite. And if the tournament is taking place this offseason right now, I'm going to kind of roll with the hot hand of O'Neill. He had an amazing season. He's the best left fielder in baseball. Like, where did this come from? Because it felt like he was just having like a solid 2021. He went crazy for like the last 3 months. And the Cardinals had that crazy winning streak to get into the playoffs. I'm kind of confused by Tyler O'Neill. I think he will repeat it though next year. So I'm not, I believe in Tyler O'Neill. Next, at number, I'm not even sure. You have the Diamondbacks with Zach Gallen and Ketel Marte. I expect the Zach Gallen bounce back season. He was elite through his first 2 years and then pretty bad last year. Ketel Marte was elite in 2019, bad in 2020, elite in 2021. He's really good. Imagine if Ketel Marte had played like on the Yankees or the Red Sox. He would be he'd be the face of a franchise. Next at number nine is the Cincinnati Reds with Luis Castillo, who's always in trade talks, and Jesse Winker. Is Castellanos the best hitter on the team? You could definitely argue that. Is Castellanos going to be back next year? Probably not. And Jesse Winker really had a breakout season. So Reds coming at nine. At number eight, here's where it really got tough here. And this top five is insane in the National League. Number eight, you got Logan Webb and Brandon Crawford. Webb, rookie season, absolute breakout, just overall dominant season. And he was really good in the playoffs as well. And Brandon Crawford was the guy who just like, what the hell, Brandon Crawford? He went from a guy who was always a defense first, never had much offense, to in his like age 33 season, breaking out, having a 900 plus OPS from the shortstop position while continuing to play good defense. Very surprising. He does not crack the top seven though, which is crazy. He's number seven. I have Corbin Burnes and Willy Adames. Is Brandon Crawford a better hitter than Willy Adames? Yes. Is Corbin Burns a better pitcher than Logan Webb? Yes, by quite a bit. Corbin Burns won the Cy Young. He could have even made a case for MVP, which is absolutely wild to think. And then Willie Adames is the guy that got out of Tropicana Field and he broke out and he had a great season for them. And it's kind of weird that Willie Adames is your best hitter and Christian Yelich isn't. Yeah, Milwaukee and Christian Yelich should work on that. At number six, you have the Mets. They could have had like two pitchers on this list and no one would have beat them. But you have to pick between one. And I picked Jacob DeGrom over Max Scherzer. And then for their hitter, it's Pete Alonso. They have a couple other options. Michael Conforto's been good. Brandon Nimmo's very underrated. Jeff McNeil, if he didn't have this bad season, could have been up there. Went with Pete Alonso because he mashes. And it's tough that Jacob DeGrom is the best pitcher in the league, and yet he falls in at six. It's just that the hitters above him are so good, and the pitchers are worse than DeGrom, but not that worse, if you know what I mean. So, let's go. Top five. We got the Los Angeles Dodgers. It's Walker Buehler and Mookie Betts. Betts slowed down a bit. He's still great. Before last year, I think he was the second best player in the league in my book. Now, I don't think... I think he falls behind Soto, Tatis, and Acuna, and Trout, and Ohtani, and those guys. So, he falls down a bit. Walker Buehler keeps getting better year after year. So, Dodgers fall in the top five. Number four, it's the Washington Nationals. Which is weird. The Washington Nationals are not a good team. And Stephen Strasburg is their pitcher. Strasburg has been okay. Well, no. He was great in 2019. He was good in 2020 and then injured all 2021. So, it's tough to know what you're getting with Strasburg. It's just that their hitter, Juan Soto, carries them over guys like DeGrom and Alonso and Buehler and Betts. Juan Soto is just so good. He's the second best player in baseball. Number three, we're in the top three here. Joe Musgrove and Fernando Tatis Jr. Musgrove had the no-hitter earlier in the year. He had the best season of his career. Tatis had the best season of his career. Tatis almost won MVP and he really didn't play that many games. They just don't quite crack the top two because the top two, I just like... Musgrove seems like a bit of an outlier here with guys like Strasburg and Buehler and DeGrom and Burns. And then the next two pitchers, we'll see. So I got the Braves. Max Fried. I think Max Fried is better than Joe Musgrove. We saw how good he was. They just won a World Series. And then Ronald Acuna Jr. I will make the decision. I think that Tatis is better than Acuna. And I think Soto is better than both of them. But I think Fried is better than Musgrove and Strasburg. That's why this decision gets so crazy. So Fried and Acuna. Can't wait for Acuna to come back. And I'm looking for Fried to become the ace next year. Because Charlie Morton, I think he's going to be injured the whole time. Or he won't be injured the whole time. Not sure. Fried's still the ace of this staff. And then number one spot. And I think the best duo in all of the league is Zach Wheeler and Bryce Harper. If I had to rate these before the year, I would not have picked Wheeler and Bryce Harper. But Wheeler finished second in Cy Young voting. Harper won the MVP. It's kind of hard to beat that. The guy who did win the Cy Young, Corbin Burns, his hitting teammate is Willie Adames. And Bryce Harper's a lot better than Willie Adames. So that's where it falls. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Kind of a weird one, kind of a long one. I'm out.